Good day, people. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, Elliott. Well, I'm your host, Shaheen. Very interesting analysis that we have for S&P 500 I'm going to discuss today. And I have a potential setup that I want to have happen and look at it, and that's about Tesla. So I hope that it happens, but we'll have to wait for it to become a reality and see if even it does happen. As far as S&P 500 is concerned, I do believe that we are completing a very important pattern on a larger time frame, and that's back in the beginning of 2022. We had a good pullback, so that was an important point. A lot of people were arguing that we are going to see a crash of the market, and I was too. We have seen a sizable pullback. The only thing is that we were now seeing prices beyond the previous high. So the only important pattern that we that can fit in is a pattern, an expanded flag pattern. So I was waiting for the pattern to give us some more indication, and it has shown a beautiful wave. The setup is amazing. So here is my analysis. I believe that we have completed the W wave or an A wave. Okay, I'll come up with W, why we are expecting a W, in case it becomes more complicated, and then we'll see another zigzag or a flat correction like over here. We'll have to So we have either this is an A correction or either this is a W wave. Similarly, either the top wave that we're expecting, which is not complete yet, is either a B or an X. And then we'll after that, we'll expect a larger wave downward. And this wave can actually penetrate further down and cross the previous low as well. So we'll keep that possibility in mind as well. I believe that S&P has quite a bit to go. Not quite a bit, but it is running close to the top. That is going to the top, and after that we'll see a significant drop, and that will be quite damaging to a lot of people. So there is a bit of time left, and here is the pattern that we are looking at for wave B or wave X, and which is in wave A, wave B, and a five-year structure. So this is a zigzag, which is pretty ugly labeling. If you look at it, normally we want the larger A and we want a larger B structure. And then they're kind of comparison in terms of time spent. But here we can see that a wave is very sharpish in kind of time. It has sometimes run out within a very small amount of time, and so has wave B, but wave C is taking a lot of time. So I believe that we have completed wave 1 and 2, 3, and we are expecting a pullback right now, and then look at it. And after that, wave 4 is complete. Wait for another push up in the process. So I'm expecting wave A, wave B, and C structure. This is a zigzag structure. I do believe that in weeks to come, it starts coming down on the down prices. But we need to understand that that pullback is only correction, okay? So right now, we have to dig on a 4-hourly time frame, or on a daily time frame, maybe on an hourly time frame, to see some structures where we can see that wave 3 is ending. I do believe that we are at a very important place. We can see the prices coming down, and we can actually see something like this. But the important thing here is that wave 1 is larger than wave 3. All right. That means if wave 5 becomes larger than wave 1, that will make wave 3 the smallest wave, which cannot be possible. All right. So we can, I think wave 3 is larger, not wave 1 is larger. My apologies. Yeah, wave 3 is larger. Okay, that's a good point. So wave 3 is larger, we don't need to worry about that. But I'm expecting that wave 5 shall not be very strong. All right. So pullback is expected in S&P 500. And then we are expecting for the prices to go upward. We can wait for the prices to come and form a double zigzag. We're expecting a double zigzag. The previous structure that we have seen in wave 2 is a triple zigzag. All right, we have a triple zigzag forming around over here. W, X, Y, X, Z, and I especially labeled it for someone who is new on in Elliott wave analysis. We do get examples or instances of triple zigzag. So this is pretty interesting. I'm expecting pullback in days to come. And let's have a look on our time frame and see if we can actually make a quick analysis. So we can clearly see structures forming straight away. Very beautiful. We can clearly see structures forming right away. So we can definitely use these points as the support line to complete a diagonal support. Okay? So we can definitely use this indication that when the diagonal support is broken, and we want the horizontal support to be given broken to confirm. In that case, we want to pull back because the price has come down quite a bit, so we need to pull back to join the trend. But this is some of the hint that you can use. Before that, we can do whatever we want. We need to break this support, horizontal support, which also becomes the previous high. So I think that if we start breaking this level and we enter into that territory, plus we also break this diagonal support, that should be enough to give us an indication that we have seen the top. In that case, we can actually go on the negative side. The chart that I'm talking about is Tesla, and I believe that we are heading that way, and I hope we have that way. I'm not exactly sure that it's going to happen. And what I want Tesla to do this, and I'm waiting on this chart. There's nothing that we have proven. This is a massive structure, and I want the Tesla to continue and make a double bottom. If that double bottom happens, then the larger structure becomes this, which is an amazing trading setup. This will become a three five setup. So we need to understand when we pull back in S&P 500 and other indices downward, so expected to see Tesla downward. It is not necessarily that's going to happen. There's quite a possibility that we already have completed the bottom here. I mean, one of the possibilities, not quite a possibility, but I'm hoping for this to come down. I'm not trading on the bearish side, but I am expecting for the prices to come down, and it does. And we keep an eye on it, and we want to go long at Tesla at $100, and then you can expect the price to go to somewhere around $300. And do understand that this is a flat correction. So in flat correction, this can actually form or move in a very short amount, in a very short way, or in a very small period of time. So we need to understand that this would be amazing trading setup, kind of a pain-free trading setup. It will be pretty safe, but we have to wait for it. I hope that I was of some assistance. I wish you good luck with your trading. Have a good one.